mission of the Boys and Girls Clubs is to serve children aged 6 to 18, help them grow up to be good citizens, help them to lead healthy lifestyles, and also we want to make sure that the kids are academically successful. We're serving over 10,000 kids, and about 10% of our children are homeless at any point in time. The secret to success, we are convinced, is to escape from poverty, and to do that, you have to have a great education. Those young people that have come to us on a regular basis and are in our leadership programs graduate from high school at a much higher rate than the average population. We also know that the kids that work with us over a long period of time have learned to make good choices around drugs and alcohol and unwanted teen pregnancies. For so long, we've been in the business of, quite frankly, changing and saving the lives of children. Without the investment in the youth that need us the most, especially those that are oftentimes ignored or left behind, we're going to have to deal with a very, very difficult and dark situation, and we can change that. Christina is an example of hundreds of young men and women that have had to overcome obstacles that you and I can't even imagine. So they come to the Boys and Girls Clubs, and we wrap our arms around them and we say, you know what, you can be great. You can reach your full potential.
I've been a member for the past 10 years. I've been going to the club since I was 8 years old. And ever since that, it's my home. I've been there ever since. I've really been close to the club, a lot of friends. The staff are just the biggest supporters ever. It's my family. The club has always been that place for me to do my homework. I have the perfect help around me, especially my senior year, filling out college applications. Growing up, my parents didn't graduate from high school. They didn't go to college. And so money-wise, financially, my parents didn't have the money to pay for me to go to college. And I didn't want them to be responsible for that. So I thought of a plan B. And I was just going to the club every day, filling out scholarships, working in the Learning Center, and competing in Youth of the Year. And I received a scholarship that will cover my tuition and fees. In the fall, I will be attending Colorado State University, and I'll also be doing work study at a Boys and Girls Club in Fort Collins and volunteering and hopefully see them doing what I'm doing today and just being that positive leader and having a positive outlook on life and that everything is possible if you just have a dream.
I want to be like them, like doing all kinds of sports, getting good grades, and just being proud of myself.
I can't be anything more but thankful and give my time back for all the years that they've spent with me and to the next generation. Giving is a gift. When you give something to somebody, you don't necessarily always think you get it back in return, but the impact is just amazing. Like, one little thing can change somebody's whole life, and it's changed a lot of the kids' life, and it's changed my life as well.
And then the other ingredient that's so important are organizations like Excel that believe in the work that we do and are willing to invest in it, and they're also willing to invest mightily in United Way, again, with those funds coming directly to us to help us get the job done.
Red Cross is a humanitarian organization that's really led by volunteers. We're there during those times of crisis to make sure that people have the help that they need. Red Cross actually has a network of chapters that it can draw upon personnel, particularly volunteers, that are willing at a moment's notice to travel anywhere to respond to an event. I think it's important to remember that the Red Cross responds annually to over 75,000 disasters across the United States. Everything from wildfires, to tornadoes, to floods, to storm damage, to a range of different kinds of events where people needed the Red Cross's help. It was a devastating tornado that hit North Minneapolis, and unfortunately, two people were killed, and we also had thousands of families or thousands of individuals that were affected by this event. So in our case, the first thing that we were doing was helping to provide shelter for people that were affected by the disaster, and that's making sure they have a place to sleep. We're providing food, cots, blankets, the basic essentials that a family needs to be in a safe setting so they can begin the work of recovery for themselves. And it's important to note that 350 people worked on the operation. 95% of them were volunteers that actually did the work of the Red Cross. And some of those same volunteers went from here then on to Minot.
Leave the light on. I'll be coming home soon.
It was much more water coming.
I'm afraid that my soul's gone. I'm ambushed.
One of the dikes breached right on the end of our street. There's houses that are completely moved off their foundations.
Some lost everything. Not everyone had the opportunity to get everything out of their homes.
And I know I've been running.
It's devastating.
And I know you're tired.
About a fourth of the community was impacted. So about 4,200 homes, roughly.
Well, the Red Cross has been extremely helpful, and is anything that somebody needs, they were there for us.
Once the water receded, they were here right now. Driving up and down the streets, feeding you.
It's comforting to people to know that they can go to a place to rest their head and have a meal.
They had places set up where you could go and get the stuff you're gonna need to clean up your house. Just a smiling face. They were just there when you needed them.
It's been appreciated by the folks here. They see the good work that's done by the Red Cross and its volunteers, and it really, really hits home.
Well, all I can say is, it can always happen to you.
Thank goodness for agencies like that. I've always been a believer of United Way and the agencies that it supports.
And now, seeing the good of what it brings to a community with the outreach that they're giving everybody, and I think my money's well spent.
The Red Cross and our volunteers are very appreciative of those donated dollars because, again, literally, it helps save the day for all these folks here in Minot and for any other disaster that happens.
On the ground, we have a volunteer that's there providing support to a disaster-stricken family. But standing right by that volunteer every single day is a donor. Supporting your local United Way makes a huge difference in the community, not just for the Red Cross, but for hundreds of other organizations that do terrific work every single day.
Oh, yes, those such a long time to feel.